We're going to start our problem with a square. Then we're going to pull the horizontal and vertical line of symmetry for this square. Next, we're going to construct the circle so that its center is located at the vertical line of symmetry and this circle is touching the bottom side of the square like shown in the sketch. Next, if we use the vertical symmetry line, we will say that the distance between the upper side of the square and the upper point in the arc of the circle is equal to 4, and using the horizontal line of symmetry, we will say that the distance between the left side of the square and the arc of the circle is equal to 3, just as shown in the sketch. The question is, with the data given, can we somehow calculate the area of our big square? This problem was actually presented to me by one of my subscribers, Andy. So thank you, Andy, for this really interesting challenge. So if you want to try this one for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So first we're going to pull the radius of our circle and label it as R. Then we will label the side of our square as S. Then let's rotate our radius for 180 degrees and let's notice this blue segment with the length of 4. Now, if we clear our image a little bit, you can clearly see that the side of the square is equal to 2 times the radius plus 4. So, this is our first equation. Now let's find another one. Let's first label the half of our left side of the square as s over 2. And let's pull a vertical line from the center of our circle up until the center point of our square. You can clearly see that this line will have the length of s over 2 minus r. Now we will do the same thing for the horizontal line. We will first label the upper half of our square as s over 2 again, then we will notice this horizontal segment with the length of 3. Then we will extend this segment with another line up until the center of our square. Now, if we look at this closely, we can see that this new line must have the length of s over 2 minus 3. Alright, so then let's again take a look at our radius. We will rotate our radius until it connects both of our new formed lines. So, in this way, we will get this really nice green right triangle, and we will use the Pythagorean theorem. We can say that the leg s over 2 minus 3 squared plus the leg s over 2 minus r squared must be equal to the hypotenuse r squared. Now, we will substitute the value of s in both of our terms, and we will get the following. We can now simplify the first term in both brackets by dividing it with 2, and we will get the following. Now we can simplify this further, and we will get the following. Now we can extend the first term of our new formed equation by using the square of binomial. Just to remind you, the formula for square of binomial looks something like this. And if we use it in our first term, we will get the following equation. Now, we will simplify some more by cancelling the r square on both sides, and finally we will get that 2r is equal to 5, which means that the radius of our circle is equal to 5 over 2. Then, in order to get the side of our square, we are just going to substitute this value back into our first equation, and by doing so, we will get the following. Now we can simplify this and get that the side of our square is equal to 9. Now it's pretty simple to find the area of this square as the area is equal to the side squared. So we are substituting the value of s, which is equal to 9 squared, and this means that the area of our red square is equal to 81 squared units, and this is our solution. I really hope you guys enjoyed this problem. If you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel. And as always, until next time, see you all and take care.